What a remarkable day. I've been doing this job here for a couple of years now, but today is actually the very first time that I get to review a solid state MP on this channel. So let's get started. Hi, this is Gregor from BassDevil.com, and in this video we will check the Orange Obi-Wan 300 bass amp. It's actually really hard not to call it the Obi-Wan Kenobi. This is a dual channel bass amp with a very simplistic approach and a lot of character in the sound, so it's a lot of fun to play this, and I can't express how happy I am to finally get to review a solid state amp. If I was born 20 years earlier and started the same thing with BassDevil, this would have been the standard. There would have been tons of solid state amp, but today everything's class D, and I think it's just very, very refreshing to get to play something old school with such a nice and full and warm sound. And yeah, if you liked your bass sound just the best way as it can be, I think solid state and tube is still the way to go. But yeah, of course, class D is very convenient, so this will be a fight that doesn't have to be fought today. However, let's get started. I think we can all agree that Orange builds the best looking amps on the market. I mean, they really stick out. I personally love the Orange design, I love the big knobs, and I love those very funny symbols above the knobs, and they are of course also very illiterate friendly. This amp delivers 300 watts at 4 ohms. They also make a 500 watt version, and they both weigh at 10 kilos. And for the main part, this amp has only 4 controls, so all you really need is the master volume and the active 3-band EQ. Controls on the right here are for the second channel. We have gain and we have blend, and the idea behind this comes basically from an old school recording practice for bass, which means you take a bass amp, use it for the low end for the clean sound, and then you use a guitar amp, mostly tube, and you distort it, overdrive it, and you mix those both together, and it just sounds big and nice and perfect. And this is basically what's happening here. Both channels can be run at the same time, and you can mix them together and just create these kind of sounds. There is no way to switch this, only if you attach a foot switch here, that's possible, but on the amp itself there's no switch, so it really encourages you to use a little bit of overdrive all the time. And I can't blame Orange, because it just sounds great, and especially with P basses or these kind of basses, it really kind of calls for a little bit of grit, for a little bit of gain, and I just love it. Only you have to make sure, if you're playing live and the only source that you're taking from the amp is the DI out, it sounds a little bit fuzzy, it sounds a little bit harsh. Just make sure that you don't use too much blend and too much gain. Otherwise, if you're miking the cab, go for it. It sounds really cool. Back of the amp is another no bullshit area. There's the things you need and nothing else. Means the DI out, line out, speaker out, that's it. One thing that became obvious very quickly when we started recording with this amp is that there is something magic going on as soon as you plug a P-bass in here. I don't know what it is, it's almost like there's a little thumping built in here that recognizes P-basses, and as soon that there's a P-bass detected, it switches something on and a little bit of magic is put into your bass tone. I don't know what's going on. Jazz basses sound fine, all basses sound fine, but the P-bass, it's just amazing from the start. I don't know what it is, it's just happening. It's not only with one P-bass, it's with all P-basses that we've tried. It's special. So if you're a P-bass player, if you play them a lot, regularly, whatever, this is your amp, try it out. You will understand immediately what I'm talking about. We've tried it with a bunch of basses, it all sounded really good. And I would say in conclusion that this is like a working bass player's amp. So it's not really the hi-fi amp that gives you all the top end and all the details and all the information. It's more like for nice, warm, solid foundation, what a working bass player and a normal working band is looking for. And this amp really makes or does fantastic. We tried to record a modern bass, like an active bass and some solo kind of stuff, which you will hear in a couple of seconds. And I think it's just not, of course it works, you can make it work if you really want to, but just to give you a short example, this is not really what this amp is about. At the end, some personal impressions. I would say this amp is just addicting. The warmth, the power, these amazing bitey rock sounds. It's just so much fun playing with this amp that it actually put my Glockenklang that I'm usually using, which is also an amazing solid state amp, in kind of a timeout, because whatever you plug in here, you don't have to dial anything, just plug it in and everything just sounds right. And yeah, I love it. So for the Orange guys, you did an amazing job with this amp. I absolutely love it. And for everyone else who might be hooked up now, there will be a second video in a couple of weeks where we compare cabinets. We have the 410, we have the 112, and we have the Isobaric 212. And yeah, if you found this review somehow useful, don't hesitate to click the like button below. This really helps us out as a channel. And if you want to see more of those, just subscribe to the channel. That's it for today. If you have any question, put them in the comment section below. And I guess see you next time. Bye bye.